Hey everybody, it's Jon Schwabish from PolicyViz.com with another Excel tutorial. This time I'm going to show you how to add some symbols into your tables, layered on with some conditional formatting, so you can make your tables a little more visual, a little more effective to highlight the certain things that you want to highlight. So for example, what we're going to do here is we're going to create this table here. It's a fairly standard table. The U.S. Department of Agriculture, Food and Nutrition Service puts out this table basically every month. It shows the number of people participating in this particular program across a sample of states. You can see here that we have four fiscal years, and then I've added a new column on the far right that shows the percent change between the first year and the last year. And then I've added a little up-down triangle or arrow to make it clear which ones are increasing and which ones are decreasing. Now, I've seen other people do this by using the built-in conditional formatting menu. I don't love the icons of that menu. They don't really look great. They tend to look pixelated. I just don't use those. I've seen other people do this manually where they'll draw an arrow and copy and paste it into each of the rows. That really doesn't make much sense to me because now you have to redo it each time you update the data, or if you make a mistake, you have to fix that. Plus, shapes don't really align very well in Excel, so that's not a good way to do it. And then finally, I've seen people use the object menu to insert shapes into Excel. That's okay, except that it's just like an extra step that you really don't have to go through to use this technique. So let me show you what we're going to fix. So we're going to take this table. Again, this is from FNS. You can see this is a pretty bad table. And I talk about this table at length in my Better Data Visualizations book. Grid lines very heavy, hard to see the numbers. The rows at the top and the total at the bottom isn't really offset, so it's sort of hard to distinguish throughout this table. So at the very basic, this is what we're gonna do, right? I'm gonna just clean up this table, get rid of those heavy grid lines, add a bold face and a line at the top and the same thing at the bottom. Okay, so now I'm gonna add this percent change column over here on the far right. And I've already done that calculation. You know, it's just the last value divided by the first value minus one and get a little percentage point in there. Now, how do we add the triangles? Well, now first what we're gonna do is we're gonna do this via a formula. Okay, so first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna use a little formula, a little if formula. And in Excel, an if formula has three parts to it. There's the evaluation, that's the first argument. Then the second argument says, what do we do if the evaluation is true? And then the third argument says, what do we do if the evaluation is false? So just three arguments, evaluation, true, and false. So let's type this in. We're going to go equals if, and we're going to put in a little logical test, a little evaluation. So we're going to say, if this thing is greater than or equal to zero, so that's the test, what do we do? And in this case, when it's true, I want to put in the letter P, and I want to put the letter P there as a text, as the letter P, so I need to put that in quotation marks. If I wanted the number 1 or 40 or whatever, I would just put the number, okay? But I want the letter P here if it's true, and if it's false, if it's negative, I want the letter Q. So I'm going to put that in quotation marks as well. I'm going to close up the parentheses, and I'm going to hit return, and now I've got a P in there, and I'm going to double-click on the far right, bottom right error space of the box, and I'm going to drag that down, and I've got my P's and my Q's. And now you're saying to yourself, that's weird. Why would we put P's and Q's in there? Well, follow along. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go up to our font drop-down menu here at the top, and I'm going to enter this, and here I'm going to type in, or I could use a drop-down, but I'm going to type in Wingdings 3. And Wingdings 3, when I hit return, is going to give me little up and down triangles. And now I've got my little up and down arrows. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just style this up a little bit. I'm going to bring that column a little thinner, and I'm going to merge these cells together here along my title here, and I'll add that underline back on. That looks pretty good. And I want to add it down here at the total as well. Okay, so now I'm good. What about the color? Well, let's use conditional formatting for that as well. So I'm going to select my entire column of data. I'm going to go to the Home tab and the conditional formatting pane, and here I'm going to go into Highlight Cells Rules, and I'm going to pick the equal to option. So here, it just prompts me what happens when the cell value is equal to, and here's the letter P. Now, it looks like an up triangle, and it is, but that's the letter P in the Wingdings 3 font. So it's kind of a weird way to think about it, but it is just the lowercase p. And so I'm going to do that, and let me just show you. I'm going to go into custom format, and here you'll see you can really customize all of this stuff. You want to add a border around the cell or fill color or whatever, Fine, that's all great. I'm just gonna use a little color here. So I'm gonna say if it's going up, I'll just use this bright blue color. It's already built in. I'll say okay. And you can see this is what I'm gonna get. So when I click okay, all those triangles, all those letter P's, right? Still letter P, just become blue. Now let's go back to conditional formatting and say, what if it's equal to the letter Q? And I'm gonna go back again to custom format. And here I'm gonna use that bright red color and I'll hit okay. And so if it's equal to the letter Q, make it red text. And now I've got that and you can see I'm all set. So what happens, for example, if I wanna change this percentage, maybe I don't want 2013 to 2017, maybe just the last year. So let's just move this over, make it 2016 to 2017. I hit return, that's still positive. Let's bring this all the way down. And you can see we've got some negatives. This all updates, right? I don't really have to do anything to change this. Let's just make this a random number. I'm just gonna use the rand command here, make this random. Let's get rid of some of those decimals. Three is fine. I'm gonna drag it over and I'm gonna drag it down. This thing just updates. The whole thing just updates. And I don't have to do anything to keep this table changing, right? And again, there's lots of different things that you can do with that Wingdings font, combined with conditional formatting to make your tables just a little bit more visual, a little bit clearer of what's happening, what's going up, what's going down, what's bigger, what's smaller. So think about making your tables a little bit more visual. Use the built-in faculties of Excel to make this as easy and as replicable as possible. So this is Jon Schwabish from PolicyViz. I hope that's useful. Hope you'll be able to use it. Check out more videos on this channel to learn more about Excel, Tableau, PowerPoint, and more aspects of communicating your data.